Well, Group A returned to the stage on last night's All Knew the Masked Singer, and once again, the competition was crashed by a new wild card contestant.
Yeah, Pepper showed up and sang her heart out, earning a place in this season's lineup, but that meant that Baby was sent back to the crib. Good Day Atlanta's Paul Milliken was watching, of course, tweeting live the whole time. And Paul, you knew who the grown-up was behind that little baby mask, didn't you?
And can I just say, and look, this is no disrespect to the person that was behind that mask, but thank goodness the baby went home for two reasons. Number one, that mask was creepy, and we all know it, okay? In fact, you know I have it at home. I was like, I'm not even going to put it on TV today because it's nightmare-inducing, all right? So it was a scary-looking mask, but also the song choice was so weird. The baby sang the Flintstones theme song last night, which I'm sorry, I didn't want to hear the Flintstones theme song on the Masked Singer, so sorry, it was time for the baby to go home. Check it out.
Who is this baby?
Legendary superstar comedian Larry the Cable Guy.
It was Larry the Cable Guy, who really was a lot of fun. And I gotta say, he can sing too. I mean, he actually was singing pretty well. But come on, don't choose the Flintstones theme song, for goodness sakes. Anyway, the baby was sent packing, and now let's move on, because it was a night of really good vocal performances. First up, it's The Bull, who I think is the standout for the season so far. I don't see how The Bull can't go all the way. Fantastic performance. He actually went down into the splits in that costume, if you can imagine it. And I still think The Bull is the one and only Todrick Hall. I mean, Todrick Hall is a singer, he's a rapper, he's a choreographer, he can do it all. And he is demonstrating that week after week as The Bull, definitely one of my favorites. I mean, the splits was pretty good in that costume. I'm like, okay, you just showed us a thing or two, so I'm definitely a fan of The Bull. Next up, it's the hamster. Did you see it? Yeah,
yes.
It was nice. Okay, so the hamster, I'm gonna say the hamster costume is maybe a little creepy too. I don't know if you guys agree.
Yeah,
I just feel like it's like a hamster is way too, you know, you want a tiny hamster, not a big hamster. Like, imagine that thing in the loose running around your house. I don't know. For me, I think the hamster is Rob Schneider. All the clues point to somebody from Saturday Night Live, somebody who's been in some funny movies, guy that's a comedian. I think it's Rob Schneider, and he did a pretty good job last night too. A lot of fun to watch, but I don't know. Like I said, a big hamster makes me want to run away. All right, let's move on, though, to the Skunk, one of the standout vocal performances last night. The Skunk can sing, all right? She is really good. She did Midnight Train to Georgia last night and did Gladys Knight Very Proud. This has got to be the one and only Faith Evans. And it's funny because this is the one I thought everybody would be on board with the guest. Like, clearly to me, this is Faith Evans. And yet a lot of folks on Twitter, they were coming for me last night. They're like, Paul, you're wrong. This is Tamar Braxton. I don't hear Tamar Braxton at all, you guys. To me, this has got to be Faith Hill. I told a few people last night, let's put money on it. I don't know if I'm allowed to do that. I don't know if it's legal that I can place bets, but you know what? Let's do it. Let's do a little Twitter betting on who the Skunk is. I think it's Faith Evans, who is fantastic, and she also could go all the way. Last but not least, got to get to the Pepper, our brand new wild card contestant who crashed the stage last night, and man, was she good. And this is one, thanks to the Twitter army out there, that immediately knew who it was. I recognized the voice. I was like, I know the voice, I can't place it, but so many people were like, this is Natasha Bedingfield. And then listening to it, I was like, yes, that's who it is. Because the clues had to do with an old song that was renewed on TikTok. And a lot of people are doing this unwritten challenge for the song that Natasha Bedingfield did. So I think it's her, and she was phenomenal. Like, now that she's in the competition, I think she is here to stay. So those are my guesses. If you don't agree with me, good. Bring it on social media. I want to hear from you guys, so you can leave comments on Facebook, Twitter, all that kind of stuff. You know, we got in a few arguments last night, which we love to do, all in good fun, of course. But one thing nobody argued with was Bye Bye Baby, because number one, again, I don't want to see that mask again. And number two, the Flintstones theme song. You can choose a better song than that, right?
Yeah, I got to be honest, though. The Pepper looks kind of creepy, too.
The Pepper's creepy.
So I think anything that's supposed to be small in real life, hamsters, peppers, babies.
I agree. Yeah. It's like a lab experiment gone wrong. It grew and it wasn't supposed to. I agree with you, yes.
That is too funny. Paul, you're the best at this. Thank you so much. Now, the Masked Singer airs Wednesday nights at 8 right here on Fox 5. And make sure that you're following Paul on Twitter because he knows it all. He's awesome.